said fucking nipples.
Okay. I thought you normally go in between them. See, well, okay. That's a bit weird.
I do like my nip-nips. Nipples!
Okay, I won't delve any deeper into that subject.
Nipples!
No, they don't make that noise. I've tested it.
Where
did 7th for you.
Somewhere around there.
You were last.
10th. Yeah, straight last.
This is gonna be a fucking... Jesus fuck, isn't it? Yep, there we go. I think I caused it as well.
You're first!
I accidentally gave someone a love tap and they concertinaed out every single car in front of me.
Non ti trai farfalloni amoroso, notte giorno di torno gerato, delle belle tornando a riposo, ma ci sento a tocino d'amore. Delle belle tornando a riposo, ma ci sento a tocino d'amore.
I'm stuck behind these slow fuckers.
I don't deserve to win this now, but that was so funny. If anyone who is in that group and will watch this video, I'm so sorry. That was real dick dastardly stuff. Isn't that right, Matty? Something you can't do.
Bastard. Fastest lap, and you're first. Shh.
Green flag, green flag. We're racing again.
I don't deserve it.
No, you don't. I missed my chance to even
Mind
try
you,
and catch it.
The only reason you're second. The only reason we're first and second is because of that drift on my.
Yeah, it was, to be fair, I still can't catch you.
Try different things on the track, and when you take some time out in the sector, you know where you're gaining time.
But the best place is just to cut pretty much most of turn three.
Apparently so!
Got fast as that for it as well.
Well, I did say try something different.
It did, mate. It worked out really well, you
I
know.
I can't really complain.
Got another time pen up for it.
Good race.
What probably going to lose my second place. Yeah, good race.
I don't think so.
I got like 8 penalties.
You might lose your second place.
More people will come, do not worry. Fuck, I've got to mute him again.
I know.
He's a McLaren fan. Oh, that's why he's Spanish.
There you go.
One sheep does plenty.
One what does plenty?
Ah.
You say one shit, one sheep.
One sheet. One sheet does plenty.
Or is it one sheep does plenty?
Ah, it's a mix of the Plenty Man and Count Dracula from Sesame Street.
I got the the Count, but... What was the other one?
It's the Plenty Man.
Oh, is that...
Plenty, where he says one sheet is plenty.
Is that that?
It's about as famous as the Go Compare Madman.
I've never heard of it.
Never heard of the Plenty Spanish guy?
No.
Never lived.
What's Plenty? Is it the toilet roll stuff?
Toilet roll.
That kitchen roll.
Yes. I think that's sacrilege if you say that to a kitchen roll manufacturer.
I think they probably produce both.
No, they do not.
Most
How
factories
dare you.
Do, mate.
They will literally have your anus in a vice if you say that to them.
Well, they'd have to turn it inside out first.
Well, you should have seen the vices they've got down at Plenty, mate. They got lots of them. Oh!
They've got a specific area for torturing.
He's giving someone like a tour. It's like, oh, where'd this go? Oh, don't go in there, son. That's just our anal torturing realm.
So this is the factory floor. These are the machines. The presses. These are the toilets. The staff room. Here's the canteen. Oh, that's the inside-out turning anus machine room. We're very proud of that.
You don't have to turn the anus inside out to be able to torture it with a clamp. This sounds very touchy.
I don't know where this is going. You have to start going to the mechanics of it, and then it just gets... Wow.
Use a very specialist vice. Butt vices! Get your butt vices here, boys! Are you recording?
Yeah.
Oh!
Wife not pulling your weight? Her weight? An anus vice today.
Anus
vice.
Oh,
for God's sake! What is the matter with you?
I didn't do anything.
Every fucking race.
What's wrong with you, though, sonny Jim?
Oh, yeah, sure.
You crashed straight into me.
Didn't even move. You still got your front wing?
Oh, yeah.
Well, what's the point in this race now, then?
What do you mean? You lost your front wing?
Lost my front wing, it's just us two.
Oh, wouldn't. There was an interview on BBC. I actually advise you, or anyone else, to go and watch it. Probably still up. Might be. It's the BBC, so it's probably still up.
They've still got it.
They're holding on to any type of fragment, the best one that they can at the moment. It's with Tom Clarkson, who I actually like. I think it's Tom Clarkson. And Christian Horner. And one of the questions was, what was the last thing Bernie said to you? And Christian just goes, fuck off.
I've seen that. Those one-on-one interviews he's been doing this season, haven't
he? Did you see the one with Claire Williams?
I haven't watched that yet, actually.
The sexual tension in that interview is literally spellbinding.
Really?
Yes! You always just like, Jesus. Just stick it in her mouth or leave, mate.
That's all sexual tension ends up, isn't it? Just stick it in
pretty
the mouth
much.
And leave.
Yeah, pretty much. This is why I have to go to all these...
I think that's what Pride and Prejudice was about, wasn't it?
heard all of these love stories.
Oh, Mr. Darcy. Stick it in my mouth and leave.
The only, like, all of the main, very famous love stories, you know, like The Notebook. All of those, just blatantly fellatio.
Absolutely.
All it is. Well, the girls love it.
It's just not a very long process, they just have to pad it out. That's all they really want to do.
I am very sleepy.
I really do need a sleep.
I could really do with a sleep. Maybe.
My oxygen levels are far down in comparison to my carbon dioxide levels.
It's very warm in here.
It's very warm in here. I'll just turn the fan on.
You have a fan in your room?
Yeah, it's out of fan. The infamous Wall of
Champions. Bastard. I need a fan. Oh, and behind you, look. I might give you a little
love tap.
Cheeky love tap. Tap of love. Why have I always started right at the back of the grid? Past races.
Cause numbers.
Because numbers?
Because statistics.
Oh, yeah.
No idea. Happened again.
Oh, you spanned someone out behind you as well.
I spanned everybody out again. Didn't mean
to. You actually did. Let's go faster.
Yes, sir.
Approaching you through that little section. I don't want to have to bump into you.
There's something that I believe some experts do in the field of motor racing. It's called overtake.
Yeah, I could overtake, but I normally wait until a safe place to do so.
Do that then. Tell me to speed up.
Some of the better thing to do, it's not really the best time to overtake at the beginning of a race.
Yeah, but do you think I'm not going as fast as I can? I think I'm going, I'm going to back him up.
I'm there.
Oh, I misjudged the braking zone, so I came off the brakes, but came off too much. I thought I'm gonna fall up way too short, so I'll come back on the brakes. DRS is now enabled and will be available to use when you are within 1 second of the car ahead in the DRS zone. We have an obstacle to our front now. I am there, mate. Jesus.
The
field is so close. It's ridiculous.
Guy is slow though.
He is. The three behind us are all doing the same lap time.
He cheats on the last corner.
I know. And he got a penalty for it. Nice one.
Yeah, man, it was close.
You took your opportunity.
Sorry, what?
You took your opportunity.
I did. It's quite funny though, because this used to be like, I would struggle to win a race here with you. But then, Bahrain, you would struggle to win a race against me. We kind of swapped.
I know.
It's weird.
It's just. I keep hate to repeat it, but it's just this handling one. It literally.
It's still not used to it. It throws up stuff all the time.
It's so much better. So
I know.
You find ways on tracks that you didn't before.
Yeah.
And that can work either way. Because before it was very much arcadey, you know the steering input, but on this you're changing the steering input on every time you go around the same corner.
Oh, where are we going next?
Abu.
For what?
I don't say
Abu Hamza hook hand.
Oh, you went even further, okay.
What, Abu Hamza hook hand? That's his name, isn't it?
I think so, legally.
Abu Hamza. A little picture will flash up in the right-hand side right now. I want to know how Abu Hamza got his hook hand.
He's a terrorist.
Especially like Shia Law, don't they chop off hands for stealing? So how can a man who had his hand chopped off for stealing, this is all theoretical,
of
now
course.
Be a...
Oh, quick, hang on.
Respected creature.
Have you just had some noise?
Yes, who is it?
I don't know. I think it's...
Do you want my mum's hand?
Oh God, I've got someone else now.
I just muted all. Nope.
Seems to work. Is he not the suspected terrorist that got let off?
We shipped him back, mate. Gone. Abu Hamza.
Yeah, but he was a suspected terrorist, right?
He was a hate preacher.
Oh, okay.
And a suspected terrorist trainer? He had links. But we didn't
like. I
was
going to say, a suspected terrorist trainer is probably ways to lose your hand.
He had links. No. Normally, people in that area of the world, if they lose a hand, then... He could have lost it in a simple kitchen accident. You never know. He could have accidentally chopped it off when he was using his guillotine whilst he was doing his English homework.
Or got bitten off by a weasel.
Or it could have been by a sly weasel. You just don't know these days. Right. But, oh, bastard, we got someone coming through Mike. It could be, and more probably, down to he was thieving when he was younger. So what I want to know is why someone who was thieving when he was younger is now such a respected preacher in that faith.
I think it's more to do with the fact he's a terrorist trainer.
he's literally the perfect terrorist, though, isn't he? Because he has a hook for a hand.
He's the perfect villain.
He has a hook for a hand.
He does, but in fairness, it's not out of choice, I don't think.
To be fair, if I was a bloodthirsty villain, I'd probably want a hook for a hand.
I don't know if Google is suspecting me of being a terrorist, but it won't let me go on his wiki page.
I wonder why. I haven't got a Abu Dhabi thingy.
Oh, you know my response to that, don't you? Oh my God, look where we are. Have you seen where
we
are?
We're first and second, aren't we?
Yep.
Fuck's sake.
Why is that a bad thing?
Don't hit me.
I'm not... Why would I hit you?
Well, I know what you like sometimes. You get all... Speedy Gonzales.
Couldn't have given you any more room. There we go. Green flag. We're racing again.
Did you...
That was my only choice, because I was going to get hit by someone.
Did you run off area instead of hitting me?
Oops! No, it's already happened. There you go.
Sorry! Oh, God! Wah, wah, wah. What happened?
Someone hit me.
Which? Woodjums. Too busy talking about Abu Hamba's hook hand.
Apparently so.
Don't get all sour grapes on me.
Huh?
Yeah?
What are you gonna do with that, mate?
Abu Hamza's hook hand.
I just get pissed off when people can't race properly.
I used to say when Abu Hamza, when he used to play pool with him. Not the fact that you can't play pool, Abu, it's because you're using a hook for a hand and it's cheeky. Me and Abu used to be like that.
Sorry, I don't get that. There's no hook used in pool.
You know, you'd use it like to, instead of getting that little tool out so you could hop over the balls, you'd use his hook hand. Yeah,
you
use his hook
hand. You couldn't use a hook as a bridge, that doesn't work.
Give me.
Okay, he balanced his round cue on the top of a perfect spherical hook.
Yeah.
Which, if he could manage to do that, would actually be a hindrance.
He was a mean pool player, Abu Hamza. We were like that at one point, you know, both of us down the beach together, you know, both enjoying bacon parties together, and...
Just give this up. Where's this going? Bacon butties and snooker.
Yeah. He loved a bit of pig, Abu.
Okay.
He invited me and come and visit the family down in his terrorist hideout in Jordan. Almost went round recently. Me and Abu like that.
Wonderful.
We are.
You'll have to introduce me, never.
No, I will do. I'll get him on the phone now if you like.
No, don't.
That's it. Not on speed dial.
No, I don't want to.
Oh. That's how I call it. That's his ringtone.
It's actually the Muslim for snooker, little peanuts are with. See, nothing about the subject is funny. It's not just you.
I like talking about Abu Hamza. He is the perfect terrorist. All he needs now is an eye patch and a wooden leg. And he will be just like your go-to terrorist. I can't catch first place. It's too quick.
Oh, come on. What's wrong with people?
Bungo!
Straight up. Ladyboys.
What?
Ladyboys.
What, why ladyboys?
You're in Singapore. No? Oh, it's Thailand I'm thinking of.
Yeah. I was gonna say. The Singapese guys are perfectly male.
They're all male, are they?
I said the guys are perfectly male.
Well, ladyboys, males are still guys. Just have a couple of bags of silicon for company.
Oh, silicon bags. That's my goal in life.
What? To have breast implants? loads.
Those silicon bags, bro. Oh, Jesus, those things.
Suggest Codemaster did some coding.
Which they are definitely not the masters of.
They are not. They're the masters of irony. Irony masters.
Iron masters.
Has a ring to- Well, that's a different thing entirely.
My mum is an iron master.
Literally everybody did a fastest lap in a row.
Someone's gonna have tears in a minute. There you go.
Guy is lagging all over the place. I literally don't know where he is.
I think you should put damage on, like very minimal.
Well, no, because it ruins things like that.
Yeah, fair.